Hi, everybody. Reese Davis with you, bringing you the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 pregame show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. One of the greatest coaches in Auburn history played at Georgia. One of the greatest coaches in Georgia history played at Auburn. These two have been intertwined for years. The Tigers and the Bulldogs do battle in the Deep South oldest rivalry. That's going to do it for us. Thanks for checking out the pregame show. NCAA college football action coming right at you. Brad and Kirk on the call. David and I are back at halftime.
Dictionary, and you might as well see a picture of these two SEC schools. Today's winner will have bragging rights for a long time, folks.
Let's head down to the coin toss now. It's brought to you by Coke Zero. Real Coca-Cola taste and zero calories. Enjoy everything.
Is lined up to kick this one off, and you can feel the thunder in the crowd as they await the start of this game. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. Georgia's coaching staff, the fans, I think everybody's been waiting to see this kid play, and here he is.
Well, he's a star quarterback. He seems to bring everything to the table. The crowd, I think, senses he's ready to have a big day. And when your star quarterback feels good at playing at home and he gets off to a good start, some big things can happen for this offense.
Good tackle there in space. So he turns the counter into a 9-yard gain.
That brings up second and one.
Second and short. Ball on the 34. Gets to about the 37-yard line. And the short gain is enough for the first.
And that tailback definitely has a nose for that first down marker.
Got a man, but he's tackled back behind the line of scrimmage. Loss of about two.
Really, they just had nowhere to go after the catch.
That brings up second and 13.
From their own 35-yard line. Second down. He makes his way to about the 45. He caught some key blocks and was able to turn it into a 10-yard gain. And he won't make it. 1 yard loss for the halfback. Thorson awaits the snap. Fielded at the 19. It's a fumble. The offense scoops it. And he's brought down at the 30. They've got to play with some focus and smarts here. They don't want to make a mistake and suddenly find themselves trailing. He's tackled right around the 32-yard line.
You know, these backwards plays can have a psychological impact. It can damage a team's confidence if it keeps happening.
It's second and 12. Ball on the 32-yard line. Rifles it right. Tackle right around the 2-yard line.
Excellent execution on one side of the ball that time. And it looks to me like the defense was in a little state of confusion. Let's see if they can pull themselves together.
First and goal from the 2. Let's see if they just don't try to power their way into the end zone here. Gets it quickly to the tight end, but it's dropped. Defense and their short yardage package. Brought down at about the 3-yard line.
That's a loss of 1 yard on the play. That makes it third and goal.
This is a very important play for both teams. It's third and goal from the 2.
To the end zone, it's always a smart play to find your blockers and follow them into the end zone.
And he adds the extra point. Let's check in with Reese Davis in the studio.
The Tigers came into the day ranked 12th. All those who said they weren't that good now have plenty of ammunition. Did not think it was possible. A major upset today. The Volunteers squeaked by 4. In other games, let's check in on the SEC, where the passion always runs high. This was a tight one to the very end. McClain's is dangerous as a receiver, and he hauled in a touchdown pass in this one. Kentucky gets the victory, 21-14.
Thanks, Reese. 7-0 game here. Georgia to kick. Fielded at the 4. He gets out to about the 28-yard line. The Bulldogs really took care of business on defense that first time out, Herbie.
One of the great traditions of college football is this defense and the way they play with such passion and enthusiasm in this environment. We're seeing that again today.
They coughed up the pigskin the last time they had the ball. Let's see if they can hold on to it this time.
It may be early, but don't think the coaches haven't spent a lot of time reminding these guys how important it is to take care of the football.
Up the middle for a nice game.
That's how we do, D. That's how we do. They don't want to run. Get along out of this.
That makes it 7-6.
From their own 33-yard line, it's second down. Now he tries to buy some time, and he's sacked. Caught with room to work. And they make the stop around the 45-yard line.
I think the big thing for a defense when they face a screen is chasing it from the inside out, which means the defensive linemen are the key to slowing down a really well-executed screen pass. Because if you think about it, the offensive linemen are getting downfield blocking against the linebackers and the safeties. The defensive linemen have got to be able to recognize screen and then have the quickness to be able to chase the running back down from behind before he gets his momentum going and can outrun him.
From the 45-yard line, first down. Throws complete. He's got room to work. Good open field tackle. And he's tackled at the 30-yard line.
That's good for a gain of 9 yards. That makes it first and 10.
from the 30-yard line. It's first down. And they hit him in the backfield. They don't get back to the line of scrimmage there on the option keeper, a loss of one. And this play is number 8 on the drive. And he's taken down at the 24-yard line.
That's good for a gain of 7 yards. That'll make it 35.
So we're looking at another third down here. The quarterback in the gun, empty backfield, 5 wide receivers in the formation. Fires quick out to the receiver, and he can't make the grab.
Boy, the defender was just sitting back there waiting to make that big hit. He realized he couldn't get there for the interception, so he did the next best thing. He timed up his hit. By the time the quarterback threw the football, as soon as the receiver touched the football, he made that big hit to be able to get the football away from the receiver.
Intercepted. Slings it.
I just don't think he saw the defender, and he threw the ball right at him. That's what happens when you focus on one guy. You get tunnel vision.
From their own 20-yard line, first down. Georgia is up by a touchdown. Stepping up. And down he goes, right around the 20.
No gain. That makes it second and 10.
Nice run, and he's brought down.
That'll bring up third and 4.
They're about 4 yards away here on third down. Inside give. Tackle made at the 27. Well, they try to keep it on the ground for the first down.
You know, Brad, here the defense just steps up and makes a play, stopping them and bringing up fourth down.
Thorson to punt. He makes it to the 48-yard line. Georgia's defense is playing lights out right now. It's pitching a shutout.
Yeah, I would not be shocked at all to see this defense be able to maintain this. Just the way they're playing, the attitude that they seem to be playing with, if they can maintain the energy and the awareness of this offense, there's a very good shot that they could shut this offense out.
And the offense will take the field, and they're certainly hoping to do better than they did on their last drive, which ended with a turnover.
Well, they're already playing from behind the eight ball, but they have plenty of time to get back in this thing.
Second and 3.
Second down, and they're going to need about 3 yards to pick up the first down. Tackled after a decent pickup.
First down.
Just throws this one away. From the 41-yard line, it's second down. He's gobbled up in the backfield. Just nowhere for the ball carrier to go as the linebacker met him in the backfield.
Boy, what great play recognition by this linebacker. He saw the run was coming, and he just shot through the gap and made a great tackle.
Credit those two defenses in that first quarter, or blame the offenses for a lack of production. 7-0, Bulldogs. Back to the action now here in the second quarter. Under
pressure.
They'll make the sack. How about the effort of the defense right there?
When you talk about a dominant lineman, this is the kind of guy you're talking about. He's got two sacks today. He can bring constant pressure. Really just a nightmare for the big boys up front.
Fourth and long here after the sack. Chapman is the punter.
Sometimes it's not the huge distance, but precision that you need from your punter. Nicely done.
In a game that's this close, you can't afford to waste possessions. Georgia is up a score. Throws it away.
Even though they didn't sack him, the pressure was still enough to force a bad pass. If you can get in there and disrupt the pocket, then the quarterback is going to have a tougher time getting the ball to his playmakers.
They line up at the 10. Second down. Quick pass. They'll bring him down around the 15-yard line. And they get 5 yards from that completion.
Here's a safe play hitting the underneath receiver, but it's a nice gain of 5.
He's finally knocked out of bounds at the 46. Now it's first and 10 with the defense trying to regroup after giving up the big pass. Completely stopped immediately. Makes it to the 37. First and 10. Ball on the 37. On the ground, up the middle. He's taken down at about the 27-yard line. That'll make it second and inches. Georgia is up 7. Fires that quickly to the tailback. He's pushed out of bounds. Right around the 22-yard line. Here's the 8th play of the series. First down grab. And he's hit immediately. From the 10-yard line, first down.
Ready. Run.
He's on the run. This is the 10th play of this drive. Touchdown, Bulldogs. He makes the PAT. So a 10-play, 89-yard drive, and they put up 7 points. kicker looks like he's ready to kick this one off. Excellent kick. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback.
Brad, as good as this defense has looked, I'm not necessarily surprised by this shutout. I mean, you and I were there on Wednesday watching this team practice, and when this first-team defense goes against their own first-team offense in a practice, sometimes it's actually better than the game itself. So they've prepared themselves very well to have this kind of game.
And he makes it out to about the 27-yard line. From their own 27-yard line, second down. Gets out to around the 38. He kept it himself and picked up a good-looking first down.
Great execution and a good decision there by the quarterback.
He's scrambling. He's tackled right around the 46-yard line.
That makes it second and two.
It's second down, and they're about 2 yards away from the sticks. Excellent open field tackle.
Wide receiver's role in a play-action pass is to get into position and to hit his spot in timing and rhythm with the quarterback. And that's exactly what they were able to do on this last play. You realize you've got a little bit more time because of the play-action, and it gives you more time to get to that point that the quarterback's looking for you to be at, but make sure you do a good job of selling your route and getting in position to give an open target for the quarterback.
He makes his way to about the 22.
First down.
From the 22-yard line, it's first down. Moore on the counter, right side. Brought down after a nice run up the middle.
That's good for 5 yards. That brings him second and five.
They'll get him for a loss.
These guys have the capability to gain solid, consistent yardage. They have to regroup, come out a bit more motivated next time.
From the 20-yard line, it's third down. They spread the field in the gun with 5 wide receivers. He steps out at the 15. It's nailed, and it's intercepted.
Boy, just when it looked like they had a chance to get right back into this game, they throw the interception. Now, it's still early. Let's see if their defense can bail them out.
They line up at the 7. First down. Down at the 18-yard line. He gets out to about the 18-yard line. Picked up a yard of anything on that run. Georgia's going to use their first time out of the half here. It's second and 10. Ball on their own 18. Tackle at the
23. They come out in an empty backfield. Fumbles a football. The defense scoops it up, and they make the stop around the 17-yard line. So the offense turns over the pigskin.
The ball carrier here was just careless in handling the ball, and a great awareness by the defense to jump on.
Offense comes back out looking to improve from their last effort.
Giving the ball away can rattle your confidence, but he just needs to relax and not try to force it. He's starting off in great field position now.
The 10. Nice play to set up first and goal.
I'm telling you, quarterbacks who can run the ball are so hard to stop. You have to scheme around them, which takes the best coverages out of your defensive playbook.
It's first down, and they'll be looking for 6 points here. Touchdown, Tigers. And he converts the extra point. A quick two-play, 16-yard drive, and the result, 7 points. So our score, 14-7. Chapman is lined up to kick this one off. Sends it sailing downfield. He's to the 20. Oh, it's the kicker that comes up with a tackle. Momentum swings have been fairly even. And with so little separation, this game can be drastically changed on just one or two plays. Georgia up 7 points. Tailback brought down for a loss. They couldn't get back to the line of scrimmage on that one.
Well, I don't think they did a very good job of selling the pass. The defense was able to read the play and come right in there and make a nice stop.
Second and 14. Ball on the 25-yard line. Quickly to the tight end, and he's tackled around the 36-yard line. So at the end of the half, Georgia in front, 14-7.
Hi, everybody. Glad to have you with us on the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 Halftime Show, presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. Davis, David Pollack here in the studio as always to lend a little perspective to what just went down in the first 30 minutes. Things are straight defensive out there right now. David, what do these two offenses have to do to open this game up?
Well, it's fun to watch because obviously I'm a defensive guy and I enjoy this, but when your defense is executed that kind of level, the offense has to be precise. I mean, you got to throw it in tight windows. You got to be willing to take some chances that you normally wouldn't have. How about some trick plays, baby? I mean, when you're losing the battle in the trenches, you got to find some way to kind of even it out. Maybe get a little bit more options, some reverses, some double passes, something to loosen up this defense. Because right now, defenses are just winning out.
I can only hope that Nessler and Herb Street will bring the same type of intensity to their call of the second half that David and I have brought to the halftime show. Of course, they always do. That's it for us here in the studio. Time to get you back out to the guys for the second half.
Welcome back, everybody. Second half action about to begin. He'll take it from the 2. He's to the 20. He's tackled at the 25-yard line.
There's still plenty of time to keep running their offense as usual here. I don't think they need to feel any anxiety about trailing. Wide receiver screenplay, and down he goes, right around the 28-yard line. From their own 28-yard line, it's second down. Throws complete, and he's got space to work. And he's taken down around the 47-yard line.
Perfect time for the play-action pass.
Well, here the defense is looking for the run, and the play-action put him in even a worse position. They just weren't ready for the pass there.
From the 47-yard line, first down. Made at the 45. Nice pickup as they connect on the pass play.
Well, they look to be in sync right now. They're both reading the defense properly, and the result is a nice gain.
We've got a first and 10. Ball on the 33-yard line. He gets out to about the 21-yard line.
That's a gain of 12 on the play. First down.
Fights forwards about the 19. Second down, 8 yards to go. Ball on the 19. And now he's got room to run. The 5. Touchdown, Auburn. The extra point to tie this game up. He splits the uprights with the extra point. And it looks like they're ready for the kickoff. He sends this one deep. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. You don't want to squander any possessions, but maybe now's the right time to dip into your bag of tricks a little. Think about some gadget plays to catch the defense napping. And he's immediately tackled. So it's second down and about 2 yards to go. For his man, incomplete.
Overthrew his man, but boy, did he have some heat on it. He just needs to put a little bit more touch on that pass.
Very good tackle in space. It's first and 10. Ball on their own 44.
Ready! Black and 5!
Three!
Got him in the screen play. They'll bring him down at the 48-yard line.
That makes it second and 2.
He
He's taken down at the 39.
It's a great job here by the quarterback of recognizing the outside linebacker blitz and delivering the football for a first down.
From the 39-yard line, it's first down. And he is drilled at the 46.
That is a loss of 7 on the play. That'll make it second and long.
Third and long here, and they hope to convert another one and keep this drive going. Quick pass, man open, and he dropped it. Thorson is the punter. Gets it away. Wait a minute, he's going to throw. He guns it right side. Can't find his man, and they'll turn it over. And the defense comes through.
The last time out, they were able to pick up big chunks of yards through the air. You wonder if they'll go back to that same strategy, or will they start to lean a little bit more on their ground game?
They bring him down in the backfield.
That is a loss of 4 yards. That makes it 2nd and 15.
From their own 46-yard line, 2nd down. He scrambles. They'll make the sack. This young guy might be feared by more quarterbacks than anyone in the country.
That's probably because he's the best at what he does in the whole country.
Third down, and they need to get it inside the 40. A screen pass, gets it to the back. He's tackled around the 46-yard line.
No gain. That brings us 4th and 15.
The punt upcoming, and they're going to come after this one. He really got a hold of that one. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. A lot of times you'll see teams start to clench up a little bit when games stay close well into the second half. You need to stay loose, keep doing what you've been doing all week in practice, and execute when it's time. Straight ahead on the give, and there's nowhere to run.
No gain on the play. That makes it 2nd and 10.
2nd down, 10 to go. Ball on the 20-yard line. Now he's got room to run, and they'll run him again. He gets out to about the 22-yard line. Gets it out to his receiver in a hurry. Brought down at the 43. From their own 43-yard line, 1st down.
throw. And they push him out at about the 33-yard line. First down, 10 yards to go. Ball on the 33. There he goes. Fires quickly to the fullback. Tackle around the 27-yard line. That'll make it second and four. He's hit and taken down. From the 19-yard line, first down. Across the middle, caught. Here's the eighth play of the series.
Let's go!
And he makes it out to about the 5-yard line.
No gain on the play.
So at the end of the third quarter, we're deadlocked right now at 14. To the action here. Tight ball game in the fourth quarter. Touchdown, Georgia! Tacks on the extra point. So a 9-play, 80-yard drive, and they get it in for 7.
Brad, I thought the offense did a really nice job of mixing up the play calling on that drive. I thought the defense was on its heels most of the drive because of the versatility of the offense.
Thorson ready to kick. Nice kick, plenty of distance. It's been a good one so far today. Let's see what happens here.
Well, you work on the 2-minute offense literally 12 months out of the year for these kind of opportunities. Well, here it is in front of you. It's a one possession game, over 2 minutes to go in the game. What are you going to do about it?
He makes his way out to about the 35. This guy just made those 10 yards look easy. So it's second down, and they're only about a foot away from picking up the first down. Nice run up the middle. So the tailback's going to come away with a first down on the play.
Solid 5-yard pickup. He was almost able to get to the secondary, but as it is, he still manages to move the sticks.
He's on the run. Decides to slide. 5, maybe 6 yards there on the scramble.
Second and three.
Second down, and they're going to need about 3 yards to pick up the first down. Play action here. He's going to scramble. He's got the corner, and they make the stop at the 47-yard line.
He did a good job of recognizing that he was the best option for picking up the first.
Down as he works the left for a nice gain.
Good for a gain of 6 yards. That'll make it second and four.
So it's second down now, and they need about 4 yards to pick up the first.
Ah,
Runs outside for a nice gain.
That's good for a gain of 7 yards. First down.
Gets it out quickly, and he's tackled at the 27-yard line.
Game 7 on the play. That'll bring up second and 3.
They need about 3 yards to get the first here on second down. He might have a chance. He kept it himself and picked up a good-looking first down.
Great execution and a good decision there by the quarterback.
First down.
From the 11-yard line, it's first down. He tackles him for a loss.
The D-line did a good job of nullifying out the blocks up front, and that allowed the linebacker to roam free and make the tackle in the backfield.
And this is the 10th play of the drive. Run and he's brought down.
Game 7 yards. That'll bring up third and 4.
They're about 4 yards away here on third down. With the pass incomplete.
He put a little bit too much mustard on that throw and it got away from him.
Quick to the receiver, and it falls incomplete. And they'll fail on fourth down. You know this is a real crucial time in the game. It could still go either way. Georgia up 7 points. Down after a nice run up the middle.
That'll bring up second and 3.
From their own 13-yard line, second down. Makes it to the 21. Carries the ball for a nice game.
Gain of 6 on the ball. That'll make it second and 4.
They're about 4 yards away here on second down. And that run got stuck.
Yeah, you're right. The defense definitely won the battle at the line of scrimmage there.
This quarterback today.
The pass protection has got to do a better job, but give this defense some credit. They've really figured out what they have to do to pressure the quarterback and to cause him some problems.
A little more than 2 minutes to go in the fourth quarter. Booming kick. He's taken down at the 47. Both teams realize that when the ball is snapped, we're one play away from a very different ball game. Throws it in a hurry. Tackle made around the 47-yard line.
Smith makes the tackle at the 47-yard line. That'll make it second and four.
Second and four coming up here. Ball on the 47-yard line. He's going to try and scramble. And he's taken down at the 30. They'll get the first down.
He made the correct decision to tuck it and go.
First down.
We've got a first and 10. Ball on the 30-yard line. Looks for the tight end, but they can't hook up. The draw. Good tackle there in space. Auburn's going to take their first time out of the half. Third and long here. And for the defense, if they get a stop, they've got a great opportunity to help put this football game away. We have less than a minute to go. He's going right. Got his receiver. Touchdown. Late in the fourth quarter, one possession game, and this is where poise really takes over. Whoever shows it will win the football game. Here comes the kicker to try to tie this game up. He makes the PAT late in the fourth quarter, and with that score, we are now tied. And the way things are going, we might be going to an extra session or two. They line up to kick this one away. He'll return it from the one. He gets out to about the 25-yard line. We're late in the fourth quarter. Great game. A tied football game. And the question now is, who's going to rise to the occasion? There's a little bit of happy feet down there on the field. Let's get the call.
Ball start. Offense.
That penalty will move him back a bit.
Yeah, and with so many young guys out there, it's bound to happen occasionally.
So we'll have first and 15 after the penalty. He's in trouble. Runs with it, and he's got room. Mack picks up about 7 yards there, scrambling away from the pressure. It to the middle of the field. He's taken down around the 36-yard line. Nice pickup as they connect on the pass play.
Well, they look to be in sync right now. They're both reading the defense properly, and the result is a nice game.
It's first and 10. Ball on the 36. They'll have one more chance for the end zone.
he's going to come up with a sack. So it looks like four quarters wasn't enough. We're heading to overtime. Well, we played an hour, and it's still not enough. We're set to kick off here in overtime. Quick strike, and he drops it.
I'm not so sure he made the best decision that time. That was a pretty tight area he was trying to throw that one into.
From the 25-yard line, second down. Hand off to the right. They'll bring him down at the 26. So the kicker will come out and try to build a three-point cushion here in overtime. Kicks up.
You know, it's times like this that I wish the offense started from the 35 or 40-yard line in overtime. I think you should have to work your way into scoring position. The way it is now, you can just start the drive and you're already in field goal range. I just don't like that.
Throws complete, and he's got space to work. And down he goes,
right around the 8-yard line.
Kirk, he's really got a lot of confidence in his receivers.
Yeah, I think he does, but in this case, I think he just threw it up for grabs. He thinks his receiver can make the catch no matter how many guys are hanging on his back.
It's first down, and they'll be looking for 6 points here. Fakes it, and the quarterback scrambles. He's tackled just outside the goal line.
Everything about that play was crisp. The route, the throw, the catch, that's fun to see.
Second down, goal to go. Ball on the 1-yard line. Touchdown, Bulldogs.
Well, that's how you want to close it out. Don't leave anything to chance. This has been a fight all game long, but these guys really put it together in overtime. Now they've got a hard-earned celebration.
And this one's all but wrapped up with the final score, Georgia 27, Auburn 21. Kirk, go ahead and just give us your reflections on this game.
You just can't underestimate a team when they're your rival, and today's game proved that. And nothing stings more than losing to the one team you want to beat in overtime.
Things up for us. 3A Sports and Kirk Herbstreit. I'm Brad Nessler saying thanks, and we'll see you next time.